What's happening, everyone? Zach here, and today I'm gonna show you how to pair your Apple Watch with iOS 11. I've got iOS 11 running, and I'm gonna show you how to pair iOS 11 with your watchOS 4. So that video is coming up. Nothing can stop me. I'm all the way up. All right. So what we got over here is the new kaleidoscopic watch face. Kind of looks creepy, but okay. So today I will show you how to link iOS. So I've got iOS 11 installed, as I told you before, and so what I'll do is I'll go in the settings in the watch app. All right. So here are a few things before you install watchOS 4, and why some issues you'll face as well. So so to install watchOS 4 on your watch, doesn't matter series 1 or series 2, it only works with iOS 11. So if you're on a lower firmware, if you want to get watchOS 4, you won't be able to. Your watch must be paired to your device before you can update. So what happened with mine was I had this paired with my other iPhone, and I wanted to connect to watch, I want to get watchOS 4, but what happened was I was getting this message that, you know, I can't do it because I'm on a lower firmware. So what you want to do is you want to, even if you are on iOS 11 and if you pair here, it will ask you to download another firmware, which you have to do, which I've done. And then once you're done with all that, then you can get, so you first you have to pair your iPhone. First pair your iPhone with a watchOS 3.2 or something, and then you'll go to the link in the description, which will be the next steps that's coming up. Choose your country. So I've installed iOS 11 on my device, as you can see, but there are a few cool features as well. So which the notification center stands out the most to me. The control center stands out the most to me. If you want to get it, I've done a video, so which you can do it as well. Just install it, it's pretty easy, and watch that video, link in the description. All right, so as soon as you get this, so once you're here with iOS 11, it will already pop up. So once you get that pop up, all you have to do is press pair. And then it just goes straight to that. So, and then it just comes with the code, and all you have to do is link it up with that code. So I'm ready with my code. And it says update now. So when you get to the screen, it says update now. So you have to update. Or it says skip the update and exit setup. So you have no options but to update. And when you update, it's going to take you to a lower firmware, but that's okay. After you've done with the lower firmware, you can install it, which will be. So you got watchOS 3.2.2. So before we can go to watchOS 4, we have to install this. And if you're coming from a new device and then into iOS 11, so we'd have to go download and install, agree to terms and conditions, and this should set you back like, I'm gonna have to wait 3 hours for that to install, so this process might take me like 8 hours, but we'll come back when that's done. All right, so I've installed watchOS 3.2.1. Went through a lot of issues, but I'm gonna show you how to install watchOS 4 on it now. So since I went through a few issues, I'm gonna tell you. So if you have an iCloud already existing on an Apple ID, make sure you do it with that. Kind of helps. It helped me with mine, and the updates will happen faster. And without further ado, we'll be right back. right there. 4.0. Alright, so now. So we got the new Siri, the new Siri face, watch face. So I'll tap on it and then I'll add it to my watch. So I got my watch here. It's no longer required. So what I'll do. So looks like we got the Siri watch face into our Apple Watch. So as you can see, so what I'll do now is I'll zoom into this. We're done with the iPhone. Thank you. Before I take that away, I just want to add another face. So tap on the watch. I think I like this one. Oh, turns the photos into creepy kind of so I've added that and waiting for it to transfer over. And there we go. That actually kind of looks sick. Alright, so what we got over here is the new kaleidoscopic watch face. Kind of looks creepy, but okay. But that's one of the features, and we'll go back into it looks normal. And if you go into app switcher, it looks like the Siri interface, the Siri watch face. And if we go in, actually let's just switch this back to the Siri. What? And there's the Siri. So as you can see, you can scroll all the way down and see your day and yeah, what's coming up. It's kind of handy, but I mean, I think I'll use it. And I think one of the favorite ones, and the reason I bought Apple Watch, was because of, if you go into app switcher, I've already got it open, is the activity, the workout. So it's already giving me a few options, so and it should be well, and it should be pretty easy for me to get started. So I'm gonna hit, let's just say this one. Okay, in 3 seconds. And we go, look at it. So we're off to a good start. See what else is there. Play music. I got no music, but okay. But you can play music from there. Add a workout, lock it, and everything is just normal. And but I'll have a full in-depth what's new on it on Apple Watch in the next video. But now you know that how to install watchOS 4 on your device. But make sure you have iOS 11, otherwise it will not work without iOS 11. Yeah, that's pretty much it. I know it's been a long video for me to create, and yeah, it's tough. It was a lot of issues for me, but I know we can get through those issues and download this ahead of everyone else and use the features, get to know them. So yeah, I hope you enjoy this. And yeah, obviously oh yeah, there's of course Siri. You can see the Siri icon there moving, but apart from that, but yeah, make sure you give this video a thumbs up, because I put a lot of effort into making this one and it deserves it. And also be sure to subscribe to see all the other features and more stuff to come in the future. Thank you, catch you later.